Good morning, students. Today let us start the ninth lesson of your English grammar, model auxiliary verbs, or they are also called as models. In the eighth chapter, you learn primary auxiliary verbs, and in the ninth chapter, let us learn model auxiliary verbs, or called as models. Okay? Model auxiliary verbs are called as also models. They are used as a auxiliary verbs, and these auxiliary verbs are used along with the main verb. Okay, and why do we use models? Models are used to express ability, willingness, possibility, permission, and intention. We use models to express like ability in doing something. Willingness to do something, also possibility of working on something. Permission, you seek permission or request, and also intention or reason behind doing something. And so these are the five things that you express. Okay, and so models are used to express ability, willingness, possibility, permission, and intention. And these reflect attitude of the speaker, mood and attitude of the speaker. Ability, willingness, possibility, permission, intention reflect or express the mood and attitude of the speaker. Willingness is an attitude, ability is also an attitude. Okay, and so permission, you seek permission or intention is a. All these express your mood of the person or attitude of the person. Okay, now let us see what are the basic models. These are the models. Okay, so like can, could, may, might, must, ought to, shall, would, will, and could. These are the models that we use as the auxiliary or helping verbs along with the main verbs. Now let me explain to you what these express, what can expresses, what could express. I'll explain to you all these in details. Okay, now let us understand in detail what model auxiliary verbs express. First one, can. Can is used to express ability. Okay, ability in doing something. And also is used for request, seeking or requesting for something. But can is used for is informal way of requesting. And so can is used for ability and for request. Next one is could. Could is past of can. So could is used for expressing past ability. While can is used for present ability, could is used for past ability also. Suggestion, when you use this you could to the second person, is used as suggestion. You could go. You could go to hospital if you are sick. So it is a suggestion. Also future possibility. In future, something that's possible to do in future is use could to express something that is possible in the future. Next one, may. May is used for seeking permissions, which is the formal way of doing. We said can is also used for request, but which is informal. May is used for seeking permissions which are formal. And future possibility. May is also used to express future possibility like could. Okay, could is also used for future possibility. May is used also for future possibility. Next one, might. Might is used to express something that is present or future possibility, both present and future possibility. We use might. Next one, must. Must is a necessity or obligation. There is no excuse. Necessity is a necessity that I must do. Also, it is an obligation. It's for the personal, first person's like speaking. Necessity and obligation. We have certain obligations that we cannot break. Some obligation rules or some duties that we can. cannot break, and so must is used to express express necessity and obligation. Okay. Next one, ought to. Ought to is used to express what is right and correct. Something that is right and correct. So there is no excuse for. There is no partial right or partial correctness. It's complete what is correct and right. To express something that is right and correct, we use ought to. Next one, shall. Shall is used to express or is used as an offer or suggestion. Offer. Some offering that something I give to the other. Okay, I shall give you some money or I shall give you a suggestion. So it's something that is offering to the other. Or also suggestion is could also be used for suggestion. Also shall is used for suggestion. Suggestion means something that I advise to the other person. Next one, should. Should is in past of shall. So it's used for advising or uncertain prediction. Prediction is something that you guess. You predict something will happen in the future. So it is uncertain, but it's not a complete correct prediction. But it's uncertain. It might happen or may not happen. And so should is used to express some uncertain predictions. Next, will. Will is used for willingness. I'm willing to do. Or certain prediction. Certain, here is for uncertain prediction. Here for certain predictions that something will happen, will take place. Or is also used for promises. Will is used for promises. Promises that you make to the other. I will help you or I will give you some money. So this is a promise that you make to the other. So will is used for willingness, certain predictions that which are will happen, which is possible to happen, or for promises. The next one, last, would. Would is used for request. Invitation. Would you come to my home? So it is an invitation. Also request. Would you pass me the book? Also for making arrangements. Making arrangements like I will make arrangement for you to pick you from the station. So you send a vehicle. So that is arrangement that we make. So I would come and pick you from the station. It is an arrangement. So we use would for request, invitations, and for making arrangements. And so these are the modal auxiliary verbs, and these modal auxiliary verbs are used to express this. Let's understand with a few examples. The first one, Alex can climb the banyan tree. Here can is expressed, or can is used to express Alex's ability to climb the banyan tree. Okay, which means Alex is able to climb the banyan tree. So can is his ability to climb the banyan tree. We will surely donate for the cause of education. Will is expressed for willingness. And so, will, which means they are willing to donate for the cause of education. Third one, you may deposit old currency till Monday. It's a permission given to deposit old currency till Monday. Okay, so may here is a permission. You may. Fourth one, he ought to take care of his pet. Ought to, he said, is used for what is right and correct. So he ought to take care of his pet. This is duty or correct of action. So his duty is to take care of his pet. Or taking care of pet is his right action. The fifth one, they should not upset their neighbor. Should. Okay, should is advice or obligation. And so they should not upset their neighbor is an advice. It's an advice that no one should upset the neighbor or no one should annoy the neighbor. And so these are the few examples of modal auxiliaries we use to express certain ability, willingness, obligatory.